Welcome to The Journey. Today we're talking about how to get started with Google AdWords. Google AdWords plays an essential role in your online marketing strategies, and it's one of the most productive and quickest methods of bringing in traffic on the verge of converting.
And while using Google AdWords might cost a little bit upfront, they use a pay-per-click model, and the benefits could greatly outweigh the cost.
Yeah, and Google AdWords offers assured and immediate traffic to your website and gives you the opportunity to convert many of those visitors into leads, which then turn into sales.
Yeah, and it's pretty easy to start using AdWords account. However, there are a few things to keep in mind before diving in.
Starting off with setting a proper budget. So establishing a proper budget is a foundational step that you need to take while creating your AdWords campaign. And this process is highly adjustable and flexible, allowing you to make budget decisions on the fly and that best fit your business, essentially. And it's no longer where you have to spend a bunch of money to purchase a billboard and you just hope it sticks. Basically get to create your budget, and if it starts working, double down on it. And if it's not, adjust on the fly.
So in addition to setting monthly and daily budgets, Google AdWords monitors and adjusts all the fluctuations in your website traffic to make sure that you don't exceed your monthly budget, which is great. So by setting up a proper budget, you can create a successful advertising campaign without jeopardizing other business functions.
And next up, we have finding the right keywords. So there's a lot of different types of keyword choices you can go with. So let's break that down just a little bit, starting off with broad match type. So this is the default match type that displays your ad to a wider audience with respect to searches that have similar phrases for your and just close variations. For example, if I put antique furniture down as my keyword, the broad match type is going to throw out a bunch of different variations that Google thinks is similar enough to antique furniture and display those to visitors.
And then there's broad match modified, which is a broad match with slight restrictions. So the keywords, they actually have a plus sign in front of them. And so the option has more control over the broad match type keyword. So for example, I'll play off of Neely's antique furniture. It would be plus antique furniture or plus antique plus furniture.
Yeah. And next up we have phrase match. So your ads will be displayed when your keyword contains the phrase in the search queries. So if my example is antique furniture and someone searches where to buy and then antique furniture, my ad appears. But if antique starts the sentence and furniture ends the sentence, my ad won't be displayed because it's not an exact phrase match.
And then there's exact match. And with this match type, your ads will only show if someone types in that exact keyword that you've chosen. Now, the exact match type gives you maximum control over the display of your ads. So for example, antique furniture.
And you really want to only choose keywords that describe your business, products, or services well. And another way you can really define this is by putting negative keywords. So negative keywords are words that you want to make sure that if someone types it in regarding your phrases or words, your ads don't show. So if someone searches selling antique furniture, how to sell my antique furniture, and I'm selling my own, I don't want my ad to pop up there because I'm not buying antique furniture, I'm selling my own. So this is a great way to make sure that you don't spend money with searches that are just irrelevant to your business and your business goals.
That's a great point, Neely. And that brings us to attracting more customers, what we're all here to learn about. And while other digital marketing platforms might take some time to deliver desired results, Google AdWords can provide immediate outcomes if the execution is correct.
And don't make the mistake of just creating an ad and simply ignoring it. You want to make sure your campaigns are optimized and you're monitoring the success or failure of your campaigns, because you run the risk of losing all of your hard-earned money on a campaign that isn't doing well.
Exactly. And your ad should also contain a clear, simple, and strong call to action, CTA for short, to encourage the user to take action.
And you can also test different variations with your ads, which is what makes Google AdWords so exciting. So you can have an ad run that says a certain phrase, and then you can have another one that says something else entirely and have the run at the same time. And that's bringing it back to that monitoring to make sure and see which one is doing well and which ones aren't. And with those variations, you can see which ones are resonating with your potential leads and sales and are getting the most clicks. You can really double down on those and get rid of the ones that aren't working. And finally, you just don't want to mislead your customers by offering something that you don't handle. The last thing you want to do is to create a negative impression, especially if you're spending money to get people there in the first place.
Great point. And landing pages also bear significance here. So to ensure that you get the most of the gains from AdWords, direct all of your visitors to an optimized landing page rather than a not so appropriate homepage. So since landing pages are conversion oriented, you want to make sure that, you know, they're designed in a way that is offers customers clarity, right? And don't forget a clear CTA.
Yeah, because sending them to a homepage, there's way too much going on. Are they supposed to look at your about page? Are they supposed to sign up for a product? Are they supposed to just look around? It's too much confusion. Those landing pages that you can create pretty easily offer one call to action, one direction to go down, one piece of information or one bits of information around whatever they clicked on. And a great landing page can contain things like an attractive headline, benefits and features of the products, compelling images and graphics, testimonials, and of course, that CTA or call to action.
Simply put, the more landing pages you create, the more targeted possibilities you have for converting visitors into customers.
Now let's talk about search and display networks. So usually beginners and small business owners struggle with the question of whether to use search networks, display networks, or both. So let's break those down.
Let's start with search networks. So when you advertise your ads through a search network, they display in a Google search results when someone queries a term that matches your keywords. So in general, search networks traffic is more targeted and conversion oriented than display networks traffic.
Plus, search networks are great for achieving higher click-through rates and a better quality score. And now display networks can still be a great choice for you. So when you're advertising your ads through display networks, you show your ads on a variety of sites. You can think back to if you've ever been to a site and seen the ads on the side of the page, whether it's a banner ad or just a text ad, those are Google ads using a display network. So they're definitely more flexible and they allow you to choose the type of content that you want in your ads.
Now let's talk about how to operate the search term reports. So search term reports are great because they let you know the intent and the language of the user through which then you can use more targeted keywords, right? So you can attract the right audience. And they even generate ideas for new keywords and exclude the irrelevant keywords, which is great.
Yeah, and these reports also prove to be one of the most effective ways to generate those long tail keywords, which are highly targeted and conversion oriented. You can use these terms to easily identify things that are relevant to your business and also in a good number of clicks and impressions.
But really importantly, we talk about tracking your results. So to make your work easier, which I certainly love, Google AdWords offers a free tool called conversion tracking. And that shows you what happens after your ad gets a click.
It also lets you identify how efficient your ad campaigns are performing in terms of generating leads, sales, downloads, signups, calls, or really any other type of conversions. And now this data is recorded by conversion tracking. Like it really gives you insights into the performing and non-performing metrics, allowing you to optimize for better performance overall.
And let's talk about location targeting. So Google AdWords allows you to target audiences by location. So through location targeting, you choose the particular areas where you want to show your ads, ensuring that the right customers find your business. So if you are a taco shop in San Diego, you know, it would make sense to do it in the local areas around.
Plus, Google AdWords will also provide you with suggested areas that you might want to consider targeting as well. So you can exclude locations that contain customers that are not relevant to your business.
Yeah, and using Google AdWords, it can help you drive in qualified and conversion-oriented traffic. And regardless of size, AdWords can help every business. Yes, every business. And you just have to properly maintain and optimize your campaign to garner the best results.
So give it a try and see if you can grow the size and scope of your business through targeted campaigns. Now, that's all we have for you on Google AdWords today. Make sure you like this video and add a comment below on something you learned. While you're there, subscribe to this channel so you get these videos.
Also, don't forget, ring that bell so you're the first to know when we upload more videos. This is a journey. Thanks for watching.